cattleman, his son John on his pony traveling, kicking up a dust storm on the plains they call their home. With them rides young Morris Youngie, the second son of old Gillungi, just part of family like his father was before. And now young John Taylor holds the answer, he's colorblind, so it don't matter. He treats each man just as he finds him. The scales of age won't blind him. I knew an old man, he told a tale of when he was a young blood and not old and frail. He did tell me of one grand place, a station and a homestead in an age of grace. He spoke of daylight when 20 men would leave the main yards, their mobs tend, and in the evening fires burn bright.
Ronnie Blyan.
Oh, please make your own.
Ken Dark.
Hey, Paul.
Victor.
Hey, Victor.
A couple of young stockmen there, Jason and Stanley. And
hey,
Scott.
Jay.
Scott.
Hey, how are you, Ben?
And Stanley.
Stanley Blyan.
Hey. The youngest ringers in the group, eh?
Yep, yeah. Bit off foot. All right, I don't want to hold you up, boss.
Right, well, we'll just go to it and we'll just do the normal sort of thing and you can see what's going on anyway.
Thank you. You want a hand?
Oh, anybody's welcome, yeah.
And in the big house where plans went down, they thought about their people when they talked about their pounds. Everybody had their own place, bought off a picture in an age of grace.
It was is that how you working for? They do all your work and no one else's? Hey, don't jam around. Age of
After a hard day's work in the cattle yards, everyone enjoys a cool drink to wash down the dust before the sun sets in the west, marking the end of another day. Formal dinners in the bush are a valued and rare occasion to enjoy the company of neighbours and guests.
Hello!
Well, that must be Ben.
It's Ben.
Yes, that's Ben.
Too wet too, was it?
Oh, Ben.
Sorry I'm late, mate.
No, I'm glad you made it, because we've really got something special on tonight, and I'm sure you'll enjoy it.
I see that.
As the wine flowed, so too did the conversation and laughter. We all enjoyed a tender Santa Gertrudis roast and fresh garden vegetables prepared by Sally.
Anthony, I'd like to thank you very much for having us. And it's been a pleasure being a guest. And I'd have to ask you, we've seen it's not all beer and Skittles. What makes all this worth it for you?
I guess a couple of things, Ben, make it worth it. When we can share what we enjoy here with people like yourselves that have come here and seen what we do and have responded openly and with a smile, that's great. We love to share what we've got. But I guess underneath what makes it worthwhile to me is that we have a big responsibility. We've been fortunate enough to have 40,000 acres we look after, and we're responsible for about 4,000 head of livestock. That's a big weight to bear because they depend on us. But when it all fits together, you get some synchrony with the way you manage your environment, the way you handle your staff, the way they work with you. It really does tick. And in the long haul, we then produce what we're set out to produce, and that's some meat or beef that people enjoy eating. But I guess the whole thing that really keeps us motivated is the sound of rain on this old tin roof. Because while it's raining, you know there'll be grass, you know there'll be cattle doing well, and that really just makes a difference. And you've come here after we've heard a lot of rain on the roof. It's been great.
I'll drink to that. Rain on a tin roof.
I'll share that with you. Rain on the tin roof. Ben, thank you.
West wind blows, smell of rain down on me.
Summer grass bows down before the storm. Light and black and white strikes out its warning. It's gonna be a while before the dawn. The frogs down in the creek break up the silence. Spill the ridge and hush before the fall.
Who cracked the bunny stand?
First drops hit the tin out on the tank stand.
I
better move inside and close the door. Rain on the tin roof, spill the good things in my life. Lying in your arms the whole night through. A whisper in the evening and an answer to a prayer. The first night I spent alone with you. The rain on a tin roof.
Well, what a great place, what great hospitality. But all this dusty kettleworks made me thirsty, so join me next week on Great Australian Properties for a cool, crisp Chardonnay at Yolumba Winery in South Australia's Barossa Valley. I'm Ben Dark, and until next we meet, ride hard and don't fear the spills.